Hey everybody, it's the Polar S5000. I'm back with more Earthbound Zero, and if you're wondering why I'm currently in a fight with some little saucers, it means literally nothing. I got 30 seconds into a recording, and before realizing the audio balance might have been off, it wasn't, but I'd already stopped the recording, so I'm just gonna start here. It doesn't matter, we've walked like 10 paces from the department store. In the last episode, we went to the Rosemary's Manor, and I got a little tilted because I was recording on a time crunch, and you can never do this game. You can never play this game on a time crunch. It just doesn't fucking work, because this game loves to interrupt you. This game loves to force you to stop and smell the roses by shoving random encounters in your face every 10 seconds. So, in this episode, we're going north, right up to where the train station is. See, look at this. We've gotten three... Ugh. In this episode, we're gonna go north of the train station. Come over here to the train station, we actually go past it, and we can keep going this way, and I think if you go up here, yeah, the bridge is out, but you can actually come up and go on this big, long-ass detour that eventually comes out the other side and drops you off right near where the desert is, which is our next destination, obviously. But that's about all there is to say about the game, and frankly, I'm kind of glad, because there isn't that much to say in this game, and to have to keep coming up with commentary about it is a bit exhausting. So I think I'm just going to take this episode to vlog a little bit. I'm not even actually listening to the game audio. I don't know, something I just felt like if I actually listened to the game audio, it was going to give me a headache, because usually listening to this game's audio does give me a headache, because it's like, you know... Whoa, what the heck was that? Did you hear that? Was that in my earbuds? I don't know, when I said, you know, or whatever I said there, I heard like this like nails on a chalkboard noise. Weird. Anyway. What was I saying? Yeah, so I'm actually listening to some music on my MP3 player, like with the volume on my laptop turned all the way down. Like, the weirdest thing ever, but it does serve a nice kind of disconnect. See, here we are, here's the desert. And we're instantly gonna start running into some more dangerous enemies here. Rattlesnake. But then it just turned out to be a rattlesnake. Neck, that old joke of me, that was terrible. It didn't even make sense. Larry, just tell us when you hear the 30-second gunshot. Oh, you're pretty tough, actually. Okay. Well, consider me... Boonswoggled. Let's just be getting mad and be done with this. This is a mix on my MP3 player that I made a long time ago. Well, not a long time ago, at least 6 months ago, when my sister asked me if I wanted to DM a Dungeons & Dragons one-shot for a charity event that never ended up happening. Oh, jeez, I have no idea where the camp is. Oh, jeez, a Gabaland. A Gab. Oh, gosh, it's Moundo. These things are so weird. I like them, though. They're kind of like the precursors to the crested bukas, I imagine. Like, I imagine that the idea for this enemy would have eventually... Oh, jeez, they have a continuous attack. I imagine the idea for this enemy would have eventually coalesced, or would have evolved into the great, into the crested bukas that are in Earthbound. You know what I'm saying? Apparently they're pretty mighty too, which makes me a bit nervous. Yeah, it's unfortunate because Sectonia is definitely your strongest damage dealer when it comes to breaking through enemies' defenses, but she also has the lowest HP, and you want her to be guarding most of the time because otherwise she'll die. Okay, can I see where the okay, I can see where the camp is on the map. Thank goodness. Here's the camp. Now, if you go northwest of the camp a few paces, you should find... This is stupid. I should have just gone to the camp and taken one of the plane rides, because you can't actually take plane rides here. I'm gonna guard, because I'm afraid of that bionic scorpion. I think that thing can turn us to stone, maybe? Poison needle. No, they have poison. I got confused because they use an item. Oh, jeez. Hmm. Wow, you guys are pretty tough, I guess. Okay, let's get... I think I'm just gonna go ham. It's fun to go ham in this game, because even if I die, you know, who cares? Yeah, you guys are, pretty buff. You're pretty buff and you're tough. Dude, stop biting Taranza, you crazy fool! He's gonna die! He's gonna die! Okay, this should kill the Bionic Scorpion. Thank you. Okay, now Taranza can guard. Is Megalore actually taking any damage? Has he taken damage from that? Stop it! Stop it! Like, what LP is that from where Tim is like, stop it? Ooh. Cold Hard Crash. Just came on the music. Yeah, this playlist was like, she asked me to do to DM a one-shot, so like what I came up with was like this, almost like a roguelike campaign where different parties, where like different people would come in and like their adventurers would probably end up dying, but they would leave behind clues for future adventurers to use. And they would take out obstacles so the future adventurers would not have as much to worry about. Where the hell? Okay. So talk to this guy here. But, and it was gonna be in like an ice cave, and the whole poll was gonna be, because it's so cold in Canada, it was gonna be like, come and defeat the winter! The source of the endless winter in the wintry cave, or whatever. So I made this whole like, icy cave playlist. Hello, sir. During last war, I laid mines in this desert. I removed all but one of them, so watch your step. Okay. Oh, you want to ride on the plane? Which flat plan would you like? Yeah, so it costs... Remember, it costs triple the price because you're buying three tickets. Because I bought two tickets. Yeah. Thankfully, it's all pretty cheap. Yeah, save your ticket stubs. This is important. If you get 10 stubs, then you can take the tank, which is really annoying because you get 3 ticket stubs per flight. So you have to take 4 flights because there's 3 of you. Because you're in the middle, and there's 9 of us, and you're in the middle. This is cool, though. The music here is cool, too, even though I can't hear it. There it is. That cactus that he circles there is what you're looking for. This music actually kind of fits this. Cold Hard Crash from Crash 2, Cortex Strikes Back, fits this airplane ride. Oh, that's an ugly loop. I gotta get a better rip of this soundtrack. Nobody knows what I'm talking about? Okay, so now we have 3 ticket stubs. And thankfully we have enough thankfully we do have enough room. Where is it? Oh, it's down from here. Here we go. Here's this. Oh, man. Talk about a lot. Oh, it's a rattlesnake. Oh, gosh, it's Moundo. Oh, by the way, I'm sorry there wasn't an episode of Chrono Trigger, yesterday or today. I'm recording this on Friday, the Friday before this goes up. So when you're if you're watching this the day it goes up, you're watching it a day after I recorded it. I feel really bad about that, but it really didn't work out great because it turned out we had like appointments at like first the dentist and then the optometrist and like first thing in the morning. So I didn't really have time to record, and I should have recorded the night before, but I just couldn't get in the mood. And it really sucks because it would have worked out great. If you know what's happening in Chrono Trigger right now, you would have known that it would have taken me about 2 episodes to get to a great place to cliffhang it for the weekend. You know, and then we could have come back with a fresh start on Monday. Anyway. This cactus, wait, a voice speaking into Terence's mind, you can see it's got like a face and a nose, so you use telepathy and you get a piece of the melody. And that is the 5th piece of the melody. Now we only have 3 remaining. One of them is in Magikant that we could have actually gotten all along if we could beat an enemy. A very powerful enemy. And the other one, where is it? Where's the camp? I went too far south. Oh, I got a Facebook notification. Get some more toilet paper! Okay. Holy cow, how long is this song? 5 minutes and 52 seconds? Talk about overstaying your welcome. Oh, in a snowbound land. Donkey Kong Country 2. What a lovely song. Okay, let's take flight plan B, and I'll keep talking about whatever. you look so happy about that. Ha ha ha. But yeah, so... sorry I missed the Chrono Trigger uploads. I did want to get... I'm gonna finish that fucking LP. I'm not gonna have another freaking JRPG. Oh, I think this one actually goes all the way to the left and actually flies over your house, which is cool. Yeah, there's Pippi's house. It's gonna come up and pass over my house. It's cool, you can actually kind of like see the geographical places, like here's the zoo, but before you could see where it went over, where we crossed over to get over the broken bridge on the train, and you can also see where it crossed over, there's Duncan's factory. You can also see where the little path we took to get to the cave that first took us into Magic Hand. It's really cool how like this whole world like slots together so nicely. Sorry, I'm drinking water, jeez. Alright, next song, no break. Let's get Plight Flan Z. Or C. Man, it's kind of unfortunate that I'm not really giving the music that plays in this desert its proper dues. Because the music in this area of the game, like the airplane ride, the desert theme, when we eventually get to ride in the tank, that has its own theme music. It's all really good music, you know? It kind of stale-links that I'm not... that I'm not getting to listen to it, but I know if I did, I just give myself a headache, man. I just have a feeling, and I don't want to risk that. What is that tower? I don't think I've ever actually been to that tower, but I think that tower like has something where you can like go to a faraway island and talk to people who eat strawberry tofu. Or no, you can bring them strawberry tofu, and they give you like the love words, the words of love and the swear words. Oh, here's Young Town, actually. The overgrown grass. Well, not quite. I don't think it actually showed us Youngtown, but it showed us, like, the train station just outside of Youngtown. That's our next destination once we're done in the desert, which we're almost done in the desert. I gotta take one more flight to top myself off on ticket stubs. This is so weird listening to this music while whatever music is actually playing in the video is going on and I can't hear it. It's like what Nintendo Capri Sun used to do to record SNES games using the record AVI function that doesn't let you hear the sound while you're recording. It's almost like I'm dissociating. Like what's happening in the game is happening in some far off realm to some parallel me that isn't me. Okay, now if I talk to you again, you want to ride on the plane? No. Well, it's quite expensive, I don't blame you. Well, dude, I wanna ride the tank, man. Well, I can't do it like that. Maybe I probably have to use the ticket stub, eh? Great, I see you save 10 stubs. Take my tank. To toilet, take my tank. You sure look happy. Ha ha ha. Claim ha. Ugh, and here we go. More awesome music as we're in the tank, and just thinking... So I talk about Metalhead Mario can move. Except we're not, because nobody said that, and that's stupid, but this thing is pretty badass, and the music is great again. But basically, what you actually want to do with this... Wait, hang on, I can't look at the map while I'm in this thing. If you remember those ruins we saw, one of the plane flight plans took us over some ruins. There's some ruins somewhere, and you need this tank to get into those ruins. Otherwise, you will die, and it will be pretty. Where are those ruins? Okay, I think I went past them. Maybe they're up further from where I saw those pillars. Gotta be around here. They are. How the hell did I miss them? Jeez, they're right there. Okay, when you walk through, I think it's this square. Yeah, you get into a fight with a huge ass robot, R7037. And if you came here without the tank, this guy would still appear, and he would basically kill the shit out of you. Like, you wouldn't even stand a chance. You wouldn't be able to do any damage, and he would do, like, 300 damage with every single one of his attacks. But with the tank, you could take him out. Look how much damage this does. Oh, he bounced back the attack! 294 damage! 200... Yeah, like, jeez. imagine if that had hit one of us? Would have died. It's a good thing the tank is inexplicably totally impervious to giant robots. Another smash hit! Star! He's still alive? Like, look how much health this guy has. What the hell? I love that they all fire the tank gun. You just imagine them all inside this tiny cockpit, like scrambling over a joystick, like wrestling each other so that they can all grab the button and push it, you know? Each one firing off a shot in turn. Anyway, that'll take care of that guy. Crystal caves from DK64 just came on my music. Fuck. I should have said that. It just came on the radio, even though it was not a radio. I should have just said that. But unfortunately, that breaks the tank. And I'm not gonna go. And don't go back and talk to the guy who gave you the tank, because I'm pretty sure he gets mad. Makes you recompense him, reconstipate him. And here we are in the monkey caves, which you haven't actually seen a monkey yet, but here we go. Hello. It's so quiet here, but too quiet for me, I think. Oh. It's gonna be a lot of oh in this area, as I'm not sure what to say about the things that the monkeys say. Now, the annoying thing about this area is I think the only way out of here is going back to Magicant, which really sucks. Most monkeys here will lie to you. Beware! Oh, shit! I like how this area has, like, the same... It has, like, the same tile set as the crystal caves in Magicant, which I never really recognize those as being made of crystal. But if you actually look at how those caves in Magicant look, they're really beautiful. I am a lady. Don't talk to me so casually. Yes. The truth is, I am a man. Einhorn is a man! Okay. Oh my gosh, the writing style in this game where you just like know when they're just and he's just like In the town by the sea, you'll meet a new friend.
Oh really? I don't believe you because your friend told me all of you lie, but maybe he was lying too. Ooh, it's a mystery.
What do you say? I've got a good story to tell you. Want to hear it? No. Have you no intellectual ambitions? Fine, I'll listen to your dumb story. Well, you should be nice to friends. That's all I've got to say. Wow. A modern Shakespeare. You want to hear about monkeys on typewriters? Look no further than that man right there. Anyway. Just walk straight. Find the truth at the end of the path. Liar! Okay. Oh, what the fuck does that guy say in Star vs. the Forces of Evil where Romulus is like, YOU'RE A LIAR!
PSI Stone. Yay.
I think he's actually talking to somebody who can't speak English. He's like, WHERE'S THE STAR? Nah, YOU'RE A LIAR! I don't know what he says. It's just like a really funny scene, but I don't remember anything about it, so like, how do I know it's funny? It's because I remember laughing at it, you know, that's all I remember. And I remember the way he says, YOU'RE A LIAR! It reminds me of Agent, White in, Iconoclasts. Oh boy. Stop singing along to the music that only you can hear, you so stupid! Another PSI stone. Well, we're just rolling in PSI stones, ain't we? Hell up, this is Timothy Bishop. Angry August. How long did you need to get here? I don't know, how long is this LP so far? I could go and check the, there's like a playlist analyzer function, like, website somewhere that I use sometimes to, like, look at which series are my longest. I think Mother 3 is my longest. And if you don't want to, go back! Oh, never mind. Go forward! Speaking of Mother 3, that LP is so weird to me. I was looking over my LPs. Ooh, Ice Cave Chant. Man, every single time a new song comes on here, I get chills. Because I just think about what it means. And the fact that I'm going to be listening to a new song. A fresh song for the next 3 minutes. Instead of listening to the Monkey Cave loop. You know, for another 5. Or 10. Or 11. Anyway. I was looking over my playlists because I closed my Steam. Dude, would you stop moving around? Dude. Okay. You caught up with me. I'll admit that's something. Here, I'll give you something nice. What? Did he give me something nice? He gave me a quick capsule. Ooh, baby. Anyway. I was closing tabs on my Chrome before starting the recording. I'm gonna give this quick capsule to probably Stictonia, because PSI Shield Beta faster is always good. I was looking through my playlist. Well, I closed Steam so that it would lag less, because I guess Steam is a problem. It never really had been before, but I'm just being careful here. And I was looking over my playlists because I realized that I think I've only done like 2 LPs of Steam games. Like, I did Plants vs. Zombies and I did Celeste, which is on Steam. I didn't play it on Steam. I played like a DRM-free version. Turn right then left to find something nice. You're a liar! Okay. Turn right. It's a dead end! Okay. Oh well then turn left though. Okay. Makes sense. I don't trust these monkeys. They're all liars. By the way, go right, left, and right. You're a liar! Sorry. I'll stop doing that. It's gotta be so annoying. Holy crap, I'm so lost! Where the hell am I? Sictonia, baby, hubba, what a dish. Dude, back off, bitch, she's mine. Okay. Oh, here we are at the end. Is that a penguin? Don't believe that all monkeys are liars. You're a liar! That's nothing but a lie. Huh? What? Do I look like a monkey? Yes. I'm really a raccoon pretending to be a monkey. Okay. I'm the boss monkey. Oh, here come the boss man! I'm really annoyed that the others tell so many lies. Go straight ahead, you'll find an exit to your right. No! Probably, actually. A big mistake. I really shouldn't have come here. That is a penguin, isn't it? That's hilarious. La 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 la. Never mind, this song is not yours. I hope it's not I just talked to a monkey and he teleports me to magic hand. Cool down, dude. Are you so serious all the time? Well, man, it's like you don't know when to quit. Take a rest, bud. The writing in this is like so weird. It's like totally something I would write. Good to hear it. It's just a game. Anyway, what was I saying? I'm not talking to you. Yeah. And as I was looking over that playlist, every single time I look over my previous LPs, I see games that I can't believe I have full playthroughs of. Like Mother 3. I can't believe I have a full playthrough of Mother 3. Because like, at the time I did that, I didn't have as much of an audience. There were like 3 people that occasionally commented, and I appreciated it, obviously. But, you know, it was like, oh, for a lot of Mother 3, when I was LPing that game, a lot of the theatrics I put on, it was like I was performing in a vacuum. So I don't remember a lot of what was going on at the time. Holy shit! This recording is fucking huge! I'm up to 23 and a half minutes, and I'm up to 800 megabytes! That's unbelievable. This is an 8-bit game. Don't go any farther inside! Okay. Anyway. Excuse me. But yeah. It makes me wonder, like, what I used to, like, if I went back and watched those LPs, what would I be like? Because I've changed, like, since starting to do LPs more commonly. I know I've changed. I can recognize it. I can listen to my previous videos and see, like, old me, past me, like, past me 1, past me 2, past me 3. Okay, I'm gonna talk to the one up here in the right. Hello. I'm a quiet monkey. I don't talk much. You see... Oh. I don't talk much, you see. That was part of that sentence. Like, I noticed... I don't know if anybody else has noticed, but, like, lately I've been a lot angrier. Like, especially in terms of just, like, the animal noises I make. you know, the primal rage cries. Where are we? Okay, so yeah, see here, an XX stone. So we could go back to Magikant. I'm not gonna do that. That's a horrible idea. Can I go back out? I can. Okay, I'm gonna backtrack out of this place, and I'll keep talking about what I'm talking about. Like, especially... But yeah, on the primal side of things, like, there was an angry noise I edited out of that Contra video, like the Contra 1 video, when I dropped into a turret by mistake in level 1. I edited out the sound I made because it was scared me. And I was like, dude, I don't want to subject people to that. And even if people think it's funny, it's like, you know, I don't want to be scary, so if people think that stuff that I do that scares me is funny, then, you know, tough beans. I'm sorry if that sounds like, you know, dismissive or like, oh, I don't care what you think, I only care what I think, but I don't want people to laugh at stuff that I'm really ashamed of, you know? And if that means cutting it out, then fine. Dirty laundry, anyone? Good grief. Where the hell is this ladder, man? But, like, In my interpersonal encounters, I find myself, I look back on conversations I have with people, and me being a grump, I've just gotten a lot saltier over time, like, in the last few months. Oh, hey, we're back. And it really bothers me, because it's like, I look back on similar conversations I've had in the past, and I see a me in the past that would have handled it a lot better. This guy's got defense for days. What the hell is up with this guy? I think he just took 15 damage. Oh, shit. Well, there goes the neighborhood. Oh no. Okay, thank you for not wasting that PK beam. But yeah, it's like, I see that past me handling things better in the past than I have now. No, don't cut. Dude, don't! And I want to know how to get back there because. I don't know. Oh, I just thought of another thing. Well, I was in the bathroom before starting this recording, basically going on the exact same tangent you're listening to right now, and then I realized I should talk about this in a video, you know, so now I am. But I could think of three things that had happened, since, you know, that had happened around the time I remember feeling like I was changing. But I just thought of another one. Okay, so the first one is I stopped updating my Ask blog, which was Void Enterprises, a Binding of Isaac Office alternate universe Ask blog that came about basically as a result of a fluke in like January of 2017, right after Afterbirth Plus came out, like right after it came out. I saw a post on the Isaac subreddit where somebody referred to the final floor of the game, the Void, with a male pronoun. Like, the final floor, he's so hard. And I thought that was so weird that I drew fan art of the Void as like a lanky, geeky, like, loser office worker wearing a pinstripe suit. With like a Void eyeball head getting yelled at by Delirium, who was also like an office man, like a big fat office, like a big fat cat office man. And it was popular, like I got a lot of upvotes. I made like two more sequel pictures, and oh shit. Okay, these guys. Oh fuck, these guys are strong. Ooh! God, no, 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 star. Okay. Jeez, man, what the fuck? Okay, Okay, you keep attacking the Altar Bar bot. Okay, I'm putting the story on hold for a second while I deal with this, what's happening right now. Okay, 5 damage, that's good. Oh no! No! Fuck you, man! Oh, fuck you! Alright, 4th D-slip. Anyway, I started an Ask blog, and it ran for pretty much about a year. The last time I updated it was, I think it was February 25th of this year. So it's been almost, like, it's been like 9 months. Or like, it's been about half a year. Well, like, you know, 7.5 months or something like that. I don't know, who cares? The point is, it's been a long time since I've updated it. The second thing that happened was in April, I got my Switch, thanks to a ridiculously generous fan, who sent it to me, like, in the fucking mail. And the third thing is that my dad moved out in June. He moved into an apartment. I don't think it would have been that, because that's been a positive change. Everybody's a lot happier now, because he didn't like living in this house. But he's got a really cool apartment in a really cool fuck, get me the hell out of here. He's got a really cool apartment building in a really cool building. He can walk to work when normally he had to do a commute. So we're actually like saving money on gas prices, even though we're paying money for 2 abodes. The pressure has been mounting for me to get a job ever since, especially since I just found out today or yesterday that I'm not covered by the insurance anymore. So if I don't get a job, then my dentist appointments are going to end up costing a lot more money, and that sucks. All right, run away. Ugh, idiot. Dude, it's a 50% chance, man. Anyway. Yeah, you guys are weak. But I just thought of a fourth thing, and the fourth thing is that in the last 6 months, I forced myself to get used to there's no way to say this without sounding like the most milquetoast jackass, but I forced myself to start taking God's name in vain, because I was so sick of not being able to say, it's like, God damn it, because it's got so much emphasis. But one of those four things, like, those were the four things that have changed. So, like, one of those was probably, I think it's probably the last one. Like, maybe I should stop saying that. Because my LPs were still good before I started doing that. I think that really might be the catalyst. That might have been the catalyst. You know, me breaking down that barrier kind of opened the floodgates on my anger a bit. The trains have stopped, the track was ruined. It's the end of the world, and you just ask questions. Stop asking so many questions, or I'll start to cry! That guy's funny. Stop asking so many questions, or I'll start to cry. It's like, what? Come on. Where is Youngtown? Here it is! We made it to Youngtown! Star! Halt!
Who goes there? I'm gonna cry.
You ready for some annoying kid voices? Anyway.
Please bring back our mom and dad. Please, I beg you.
Oh, you know what another reason is for why there weren't any episodes yesterday or the day before? This time I'm referring to Friday and Thursday there when I say yesterday and the day before, not relative to the day I'm on, relative to the day this is going up. Really confusing. It's because I got Dead Cells and I literally have to physically pull myself away from that game. That game is so fucking good.
Please hold me!
Such primal. It's just. Someone crying out for someone to hold them is such a primal emotion. It just gets to me on this, like, deep level. Oh, stop talking to people. Okay, so, is it in here? No. So basically the idea behind this town is that all the adults have gotten kidnapped. The adults have all disappeared. It's like that. It's like the Jimmy Neutron movie, you know? No parents. I like when they're grown-ups around. Sure I do. Aww. Fuck. This is depressing. A big ship from the sky took mom and dad away. Aliens? It really is the Jimmy Neutron movie. There's a church somewhere around here with a baby in it. And that baby has the most valuable fucking thing in the whole game. I miss you! Boy, two clowns singing with one voice. Anyway. Ah, I wish my eyes were cock-jacking. I went to the optometrist this morning, and my eyesight has always been perfect, so pretty much every time I go to the optometrist knows it, like, it's almost like a game. We're gonna, like, okay, has anything changed? And then nothing changes. I still read everything, like, pretty much perfectly. I made one tiny mistake today. I read a P when it was an F. 2 + 3 = 5. 8 - 4 = 4. I study all the time. Really. This sign that says Jack is actually a hotel. This guy will let you stay for free. Well, that is no one. I don't care about money. So if you need a place to stay, feel free to stay here tonight. Sure. So I tried to let the bed bugs bite. But yeah, so we went to the optometrist, and he did this thing which I don't remember him do. I vaguely remember doing it before. But it was like these little. It was like these little eye. These like eye drops to test the eye to test the pressure of my eye. And oh man, it was so. Oh, it stung, man. And not only that, but like, it was like this yellow stuff. Like the napkin looked like I'd spilled turmeric on it. And because I didn't realize I could get it out of my here's the air gun. I didn't realize that I could wipe it out of my eyes pretty basically as soon as it fell in. Like I didn't need to keep it in my eye for any reason. I didn't realize that. So by the time I got it out of my eyes, my right upper eyelid had gone numb. And that is an uncomfortable feeling. Okay, let's withdraw like $1,500. Who cares? We've passed the point where we don't really need to worry about money anymore. Okay, I want an air gun. Yes. This is a very good weapon for Lloyd, and it's also his pretty much his ultimate weapon. It's his last and strongest weapon. It's better than the boomerang actually, which is interesting. I thought it wasn't, but it is. 74. What's mine? Mine is 88. So it's a 74. And it goes up to 84. Yeah, full 10. Not bad. What was I saying? Man, I'm so stupid. I can't remember what I was talking about like 10 seconds ago. But yeah, like my upper eyelid went numb and that was so uncomfortable. Ah, my eyes are still itching. I should have gotten those out of my eyes faster, but apparently it's not bad. But apparently it's harmless, so at least there's that. Okay, where's the church? There's a church somewhere around here. It's not there. Is it not this church? Somewhere around here is a baby, and you have to use telepathy on him. And it's really important that you do. This is the shop. Yeah, I was just in there. Is he not? Is he in here? No. I thought his name was Jack, but apparently not. I thought his name was Jack. I thought he was in a church, you know. So I've looked in the place called Jack, and I've looked in the church. I don't get it. Where is the heck? What the heck is this music? Oh, this is Tropical Freeze I'm listening to. I need to play Tropical Freeze again. Here we go. Here's the house. It's the girl here. It says, Mom told me this baby has mystic power. Oh yes, my name is Tom Garrickson. I like to introduce myself. It's my hobby. And here's the baby. I wish that Sectonia didn't have to be dead for this, but... Googa! Use telepathy on the baby. And he says, yes, even though my body is that of a baby, I possess psychic abilities. You may not be able to understand my emotions. Though I have a baby face, I possess the mind of an adult. I know the power of teleportation. Yes! Use this power to return to a place you've been to. The baby taught them his power of teleportation. And just like that, we now basically have free healing. Because we can warp back to Magicant and then teleport out. And that's awesome. So is there anything else we can do? I feel like maybe I should go try to go fight the dragon. You guys might have seen the dragon in Magic, and maybe I can try that. You know what? Let's do that. Let's go try to fight the dragon, because now we can teleport back here whenever we want. I mean, we could always do that, but now we can go back. Now we can teleport back, too. And Youngtown is one of the destinations, so it's really easy to get back there. Okay, I'm the Mysterious Goods Keeper. I want to give you my ghost key. Man, I gotta play Tropical Freeze again. The problem is I have it on Wii U. Well, it's not a problem, but I don't know. I remember not being impressed with it when I first played it, but I mean, all the analysis videos sure make it sound good, so I'll give it another shot. I mean, it was good, it just wasn't that memorable. Like, it was really, really, really good and satisfying, got fantastic level design, but I just don't remember much of it. And, like, I don't care what anybody says. They have to bring back the Kremlings. The Snomads just aren't as cool. I mean, they were cool, but it was just like, oh, it's a Viking clan, you know, and that was all there was to it. There was it wasn't personal. Like, King K. Rool is so much more interesting because it's personal. And he's also crazy, you know? He's not just a, you know, plain old, I'm an evil overlord, me. Anyway, okay, so I'm gonna save. No, I'm not. Because I don't need to. Let's go see if we can beat the dragon. I think we should be able to. It'll be touchy, but it shouldn't be too much of a problem as long as we can get a PSI shield off. We have H2O pendants, so the dragon's most dangerous attack, which is his ability to breathe fire, will be mitigated by that. I don't know why I needed to specify by that. Okay. And if we can get a shield up, then that'll only make it easier. And then we can basically just wail on him while keeping our HP up. It'll still be interesting, but it won't be that. But, I mean, this is of course assuming that he doesn't just kill one of us on the first turn, which is very possible. And that would make it much harder and less fun. Oh gosh, it's Groucho! Man, this music is really good. What is this? This is Aqueduct Assault. The problem is, like, see, here's kind of an unpopular opinion I have about music. Like, mostly, like, modern Nintendo music. Like, Mario Odyssey, Mario Kart 8, Tropical Freeze, you know, all those, like, modern, you know, ever since, like, the Wii U. It feels like... I don't know. This is just my two cents, and I'm not a fucking musicologist, but it feels like the composers are focusing more on making a technically impressive composition than they are focused on delivering memorable and catchy melodies, which is what made the old music so memorable and so classic, you know? Like, it doesn't matter how great a soundtrack is if you don't remember it. Anyway, here we go. But maybe I'm just being an asshole. It certainly wouldn't be the first time. excuse me. I'm gonna give this Franklin badge to Cytonia, because it's more important for her to have it. Anyway, here we go. Check. The dragon sleeps. Dragon's psychic power is short of what is what? 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 Huh? What? Is there a minimum level for this? There must be a minimum level. Oh my gosh, man. I can't believe it, man. What a goof! Oh, what is this one called? This is, Forest Folly. I should just fight you guys. get what little experience you give me to get me up to the required level, question mark? How do people do low-level runs in this game if you need to be a certain level to fight the dragon? Is that not what it is? But I have every other melody that you can get, except the last two, which are both in the final area. What am I missing? Did I forget to do something? Maybe I needed to, maybe there was somebody in the monkey caves I needed to talk to? Boy, wouldn't that be stupid. Okay, well, let's go back to Magic Ant and then, you know, do some little maintenance in this episode. We finally picked up the sword from that present box that's been there the whole time. Let's give it to the mysterious goods keeper, because we're not going to need it for a while until we cross the swamp, which is going to be... Oof. Nope, that's good. Let's talk to the mysterious mimicker. $916. Anyway. 1979. Could. Okay, 367 for Taranza, 344, 148. Yes, I do. Huh. Oh gosh, I have to burp. Oh, would you just come burp? Seriously. Okay, well, I saved my game. So next time, I shouldn't. How many times am I gonna do that? Save the game at the end of a recording, you know, regardless of the fact that you need to make sure the recording turned out first.